Friends, as all of us we know that now the COVID-19 is spreading across the globe, and in India also there is a lockdown across the country. So NCERT took this initiative forward, and from 7th we have started a webinar with teachers, teacher educators and parents as well. And we have been interacting with many stakeholders. Today we have Mr. S. Dilip, who is a resource person for this session. And this session will be mainly dealing with some web tools related to teaching of English. And Mr. Dilip is a national ICT awardee teacher from Tamil Nadu, and has a vast experience of teaching of English in the state, as well as he is a national resource person as part of this ICT initiative. My colleague Dr. Midhi Singh from CIET, assistant professor, he is also a co-host and moderating this conference, and she will be with us. Dilip ji, please go ahead.
Thank you so much for the introduction as well as for the instructions. Let me start with, let me introduce myself as sir already had introduced. Thank you so much for giving me this wonderful opportunity. I'm Dilip, working as an English graduate teacher in Government Higher Secondary School, Satyamangalam, Tamil Nadu. And here in this today's presentation, I'm going to give you five wonderful tools which are highly beneficial for English teachers, and I'll also share two resources which are common for all the subjects. First, let me start with one web tool. The name of the web tool is Text-to-Speech. Generally, we used to use this when we are recording a movie. When it is concerned with English, we'll not have appropriate pronunciation. Sometimes we may mispronounce the words. For that, we can get the audio generated from online tools like From Text to Speech is one, which gives us the exact pronunciation of the words, and we can get it as audio recorded file as MP3 format, and we can incorporate that video with our any of the presentation where the voiceover will be system generated. And this is one. And next, already in the first session itself, Madam Sangeeta Gulati had gave us a detailed presentation about all the Google tools. Here, I am going to give you one tip which will help any language teacher or English language teachers to not by typing. We can type in Google Docs with speech. Here, we have this wonderful tool where we can speak and make the artificial intelligence to type for us. Let me give you a demo of that. It works with Tamil as well as for Hindi, and it works for Kannada also. You might be from any regional language. If you wish our artificial intelligence to type for us, you can speak like this and your computer will type for us. This is second tool which I wish to introduce for you. And next, if you are good with phonetics and you want your children to articulate through transcriptions, we will find it difficult getting the typed font of transcription. Here, this website, tophonetics.com, will convert all your normal text into phonetic text, which is a wonderful tool for a language teacher, especially English language teacher. And the next thing which I am going to introduce is the Office package consists of OneNote, where we have grammar segregations and the text-to-speech inbuilt engine, which helps a teacher to classify the grammar parts which are already there in the paragraph, which is in your prose or poem or any of your lessons. This engine separates you with this. Let me also explain you this at last. Wonderful website which kids really enjoy. My students enjoy playing the downloaded games from this. All these are free of cost. GamesToLearnEnglish.com is one website which gives you online games to play and learn English grammar, as well as it gives you interactive games which are helpful for a teacher to play. When you have interactive whiteboard in your classroom, you can allow your children to interact with your smart board. These are the five tools which I wish to share with you. Let me give you one by one as a demo. Now I have entered into a website where you can see the name of the website is FromTextToSpeech.com is the website. In this, you can freely type any text like, hello, everyone. I welcome you all to the session. Is typed, you can paste anything here, which is already there in your e-textbooks or anywhere. And here you're going to select, we generally follow UK English. So instead of US English, I'm changing this to British English. And there are two inbuilt voices which are available. One is Emma, which is a female voice, and Harry is a male voice. And you can select any voice here. And you can also select the speed of the pronunciation. Like it could be slow if you are going for primary children, and it could be medium for upper primary, and you want it fast or very fast, you can select accordingly. I have given medium, and just that's all. You can create your audio file, click create audio file, and now your audio file is ready for you to download. Just give download audio file. And
hello everyone, I welcome you all to the session.
This is system generated voice, and you can use this as a background for slides where you will have accurate pronunciation of words when you are teaching with pronunciation. But I strongly agree with teacher's voice, which has a personal touch with children. Whenever you want to explain things, you can use your voice, and when it is pronunciation, when it goes with pronunciation, then we wanted to use this, and we have made use of this for e-glossary creation in Diksha platform because we are not that appropriate with our pronunciation, so that we have used this system generated voice. And you can download like you can paste paragraphs, and you can change the voice, and you can download it as audio file into your downloads folders, and then you can make use of that voice. This is number one tool which I am using. Next, I'm moving on to my next tool. The website address is tophonetics.com. Tophonetics.com is the website ID. And here again, we are dealing with teaching of English today. Changing the text. So you have British, American, and you want transcription only. And you can select from this. My internet connection is unstable. Show transcription. Let me give. And now my transcription is here. You can find this. We are dealing with teaching of English today. Is transcribed for me as transcription by system, and you can make use of this to change all your text which are given in your textbook into transcription. This helps us to read appropriate, like we are. This is how we are going to read the text with this. And again, here also you have automatic reading facility in the website. Here I'm giving the reading option.
We are dealing with teaching of English today.
And here we have the fast and the slow speed adjustment is also there in the website. So you can adjust that.
We are dealing with teaching of English today.
Now it's a bit fast.
We are dealing with teaching of English today.
You want to make it slow. This is how you can make use of this website. And again, this is available in Apple and Google Play Store. You can make use of the apps as well. And next, as I have told you that gamification plays a vital role in teaching of any subject. I have done a project for like gamified grammar, teaching grammar with the help of games. So I have made use of this website, which is free of cost. Here you can play online with any of this vocabulary development, fast phrases, and fast vocabulary. Let me check. Only one I'll take and play for you. And if you start this, you have this many categories of classified vocabulary. This will help from primary, first standard to eighth standard. Now let me select animals category. And here you have this. Your just drag and drop matching. You will have here, listen to the pronunciation as well.
Fish.
And?
Monkey.
This is how there are so many games inside this package. There are more than 25 to 30 online games. And let me show you downloadable games which are played offline. This is online. Here in this, on the upper menu, you could find for vocabulary separate, phrases, spelling, and describer. These are online games. And come down in the website itself. Here you will find download option. And especially for whiteboard, you have some games to download. I'm clicking on download option now. Here you have, you can just drag, just click on that icon. Then you can directly play. No need to install this into your, again, into your system. You can save it in the folder. You can open it and play it. Here we have vocabulary as well as Spelling Bee is a wonderful vocabulary game which helps the children to develop their spelling for a different category. And this is one which I love and my kids also love. Speedball is like Hangman Auto is also there. Hangman is a generally played, we play it without computer in the classroom also. This is computer generated Hangman for vocabulary. All these games are free to download. And if you want me to download and show, I'll just click this. And it is downloaded as a RAR file. Just unzip this and you can open and play this. This is about that. And let me give you a demo of OneNote. And now this is downloaded. And you are looking into that, I think. Now I am going to unzip this, extract to desktop. Now you have downloaded that as a RAR file. And you have unzipped it, like clicking this, extract to desktop. So that you will get this folder. And now Fast English is as an application, it had unzipped. And you can double click this and play the game. This is how we are downloading this and playing it offline without any internet connection. It is possible to play 22 games in your classroom to develop both grammar as well as vocabulary. And now let me go with OneNote, which is inbuilt with Office. Is the OneNote file showing, ma'am? English prepositions, a preposition. Is it visible now?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. And here, there is one tool in this called Learning Tools. I'm telling you about this. Learning Tools for OneNote. This will not come along with the package. You just wanted to download this from like Get app. And you will download it from office.com. This is also free for education. And when you go with that, Learning Tools helps teacher to go with Immersive Reader as well as Dictate is the facility which is available. Now let me give you a brief introduction about Immersive Reader. And there is raise hand from Abhishek and I'll answer you later, sir. One second. Immersive Reader, let me open it and show you what are the facilities available here. This is one where you can make all the text read without going online. So I'll give the play icon.
English prepositions. A preposition usually comes before a noun or pronoun.
So this is system generated voice, which will give you a model reading, and we can follow that reading before entering into the class. Also, we can make practice of exact pronunciation of the words with this, and you can also display this in smart board. And let me show you the other facilities which are available here. So you can change the text size with one click like this. If your students on the back benches feel it is not visible, so you can increase this. And the spacing between the letters can also be classified with this. And the backdrop, if you find it, color balance can be changed with one click from here. These are for specially able children in our classroom. Like for eye blindness, we can make use of increasing. Visually challenged will need bigger size fit properly. You can make use of this. Then let me move on to the next icon, which shows you the book. And here, comprehension. So if you click on comprehension, verbs will come in different color. You are seeing the verbs from this as red in color, like dictates, comes, and other verbs go with. Let me scroll down. All the verbs are colored in red now. It's automatic. And next, let me click the nouns. Then immediately all the nouns will be colored in violet. It is also by system which does this for us. And if you want adjectives to be classified, just click adjectives, which will be like this in color. If I change the color background, you will easily come to know all different elements. So now all the nouns are in violet color. All the verbs are in red color. And in green color, you can find all the adjectives. This is like the system which helps us through artificial intelligence. It segregates everything. And the best thing about this is syllabifying. If you click on the syllables, it automatically syllabifies the words, which helps the children to read it very easy. Like here, English is syllabified. Prepositions is again syllabified. And if you make play also, it will play for you.
English prepositions. A preposition usually comes before a noun or pronoun.
Okay, these are the facilities which are available. And here at last, you can again change the voice speed. And again, you have three voice selections here. You can change the voice here and...
And dictates its relation to an...
This is another voice. And if you want a male voice, you can change it.
Another word, often regarding time or position. There are many prepositions in the English language. Some common English prepositions are above, behind, between, opposite, under.
Okay, these are the facilities which are available with the learning tools which are with this. Here you have learning tools which is add-on for this OneNote. With this, you can make use of this. Let me give you one simple technique for the maths teachers. That is, if you click on the question and if you click enter, it automatically gives you the answer here, which is a good item, which I like in this. Like 345 into 45 is equal to, just click enter so that the answer system gives you automatically here. And it goes with like all basic apps here, and there are much of things which are here, drawing and everything. I don't want to concentrate on all this. The language items which are good with this or with the learning tools which I have explained you, and I can tell you about the last tool which is here, Quizlet.com. This is a place where the teachers can create resource without much of pain. And I have already signed in with my account here you can find my name. And if you want to sign in as new, no problem. It is a free version for certain level, and you can sign in with your Google account or any of the email account, or you can sign up for this and you can enter like this. This is the last tool which I am going to explain you. And when you enter inside this, you will go for create here. I'm just clicking on create. And after create, you will give the title of your presentation, and you're going to explain this, and you're going to give one example type as apple, which is about a noun. And here you are going to search for the image, which is I have already given. And if you want the system to give you, you just click on image and it will automatically search for you, and it will give you the images. You can select one from that. And now second one, I have typed cat. Now I am moving on to this is again a noun, and will give you select the image from the below one. I've selected one image, and I'm going to add cart. Now just let me go with any verb with walk as a verb. And now I'm searching for walk. Just I have picked one out of this, and just these three enough. I'll just click on the create icon here. You need to choose a definition language to create a set. Okay. Just wanted to insert two more, five at least. And I'm typing one more with an explanation, this as adjective. And you are just typing, this could be of any, for maths also, you can type that and the definition here. I go with one more, which is of kind of thing. Now it is saving for me. Just this is what, like, you wanted to create with minimum five cards, so that it asked me for this. And now you will get the link, which can be shared in either Google Classroom, or you can copy link and share this to your students. The magic of this is, like, let me show you. I'm not sharing it anywhere. I'm just copying the link and I'm going to close it. Now you have typed five cards. It will give you as flashcards and learning cards, writing cards and spelling and other things. Just it will give you like this as a flashcard where you can edit this. This is like a learning card definition. Click here to see the definition, and if you click, it will show you like this. And next, the flashcard is like this. It will show you the word. And if you click like this, it will show you with an image like this. This is for learning purpose. And if you click this, it will show like this. And if you click again, it will show the other side of the flashcard. This is like a virtual flashcard. It automatically generates for you. And I go for learn is the second one. Here, it automatically creates you a system generated test here. Adverb, which of this is an adverb, it is asking. So let me go with slowly, and if you give it correct, it will show right answer. So you haven't created any MCQ or flashcards, just you have typed in five words with images. system automatically creates you test, game, and explanation like this. Verb, you are going to click here by looking into this. This is walk. So like this. And let me give a wrong answer now. Noun, and which of this is a noun according to this? This anyone can answer, apple. But let me give it wrongly. And it will redirect you to study this one. Like you go to this card and study. And
noun.
So this is also automatic.
Apple.
So you study this and press any key to continue now. So like this, you will get a test one option. Let me go back. And for writing, you will have one here. On the left hand side, you have typed in one, it gives you five. One out of five is this. And for spelling, adjective, it gives you type the answer. Which one of the adjective we have given is, I guess, beautiful is one. I'm not sure. Let me check. Yes, I'm right, correct. And press any key to continue. And noun, this one, you all know that this is cat. And this is for typing, which is for spelling. The students can learn spelling and writing out of this. This is for making it as a writing skill. So adverb, what adverb have we given? If I'm not wrong, slowly. So it's again correct. And again, we have given this as a wrong answer. So I wanted to type it right. Let me misspell it like APLE. Let me check what happens. And override, I was right, but the correct answer is apple. It gives you the right answer.
Apple.
So we can learn from this. And I have shown you the demo of flashcards, learn, write, and spell. At last, you will have a test. And there are games also inbuilt with this. Let me play one game and you can check with the other. I guess my time is running out, if I'm not wrong. And I'll give you the test. Here, you are going to type the answers like a question paper. It had given you one as MCQ, one as true or false, and two as typing. And with the five inputs, it has given you lots of bundle for classroom. Now, let me go back and play you the game. First game is matching game, start game. And how are we going to match this is, and I go with this noun, this is like this. You are dragging and like walk. I want to drag and drop here. You want to match. This is the game about. You want to finish this within the prescribed time. Is that? And now let me go for the gravity. The last game, which is created for us. And you can select the levels. Study star like this. And answer with term and all this easy, medium, hard, we can select and start game. You want to look into the question and type the answer. Beautiful, what is beautiful? It is adjective. So if you type in the right answer, your asteroid will go out or else it will hit the ground and you will get out. Noun. Okay, like this, it creates automatic game. So that this is a quick demo of that. Let me go back, quitting this game. And I'll give you a quick recap of what I have given. You're going to create an account in Quizlet.com, Quizlet.com. And where you're going with sign up or sign in if you have already account. And you're going to click create, where you're going to type in the words and explanation and add an image. And system generates you flashcards, learn, write, spell, and test. And for games, matching and gravity. This is all about, like, let me have a quick recap of what I have shared is. We have given with how are we converting the type of text into audio generation with fromtexttospeech.com. And second, we have seen with tophonetics.com where system converts your type text into a transcription, which is highly impossible for an English teacher to get the fonts of transcription, and typing it again will give us a lot of tedious work. Again, we will not know whether it is one question is can be used this in Android mobiles. I'll answer it after this. And third one, I have given you, I haven't given a demo. If time permits, I can give you a demo of how can we input voice to text in Google Docs. Okay, let me share screen and show you. That is again amazing one, which is like I haven't shown you that thing, I think. Now again, Sangeeta ma'am had given us a beautiful explanation of how to go inside this docs.google.com. So I'm directly going into Docs. I'm opening with a blank presentation. I'm not going to type it. I'm making the system to type for me. I'll show two things. I'm just clicking in Tools and click Tools. I go with voice typing. I guess it's visible. Am I right, ma'am? Niti ma'am? Is everything visible? Okay. Then go for voice typing. You have a shortcut, Control plus Shift plus S. I click voice typing. Now here the default language is English, US. And just click this. And you can change the language like English, India. And I'm going to click to speak. I'm making my computer to type for me. I'm not touching my keyboard at all. You can see my hands in rest and my system is typing for me. You can type a number of pages just by dictating it to Google. Your docs will do that. This is an amazing tool which helps me in typing text, creating question papers and everything. You can type it here and copy it and paste it in Google Forms and anywhere you wish. And it had done for me. And one more thing which I love is, let me stop here. And this is not only for English. This is for all regional languages which are visible here. I will show you with this with Tamil, because I know another language is Tamil. Hindi, I'm not sure, but you can check with that. But Hindi is also available. I have checked with this. Hindi is available here. You can also try typing in Hindi. And I go with Tamil here. And let me start typing in Tamil. Naan tharpozhudhu Tamilil tattachu seidhu kondullen. Idhu naan pesuvadhai thaanaga ganini enakkaga tattachu seidhu kodukkirathu. Idhan moolam naan ethanai pakkangalai vendumanalum miga elimayaga tattachu seiya mudiyum. And if anyone can help me in Hindi, let me try with one simple word which I know in Hindi. Let me check with that. But you want to guess whether it is right or not. I'm not sure about that. Let me go with Hindi. I hope this is Hindi. Am I right?
No, sir. The next one.
This one.
This one.
Yeah. Okay. Now I'll talk like Mera naam Dilip hai. To Hamara class padte hai. I'm not sure, but I can't check this. Uh-huh. You can use this and check.
Uh-huh. Aap boliye sabhi ko namaskar.
Okay. I'll sabhi ko namaskar.
Very good. Aaya hai namaskar.
Okay, sir.
Sabhi ko dhanyavad, nandri.
Okay.
Can you just repeat this, how to open? Somebody is asking. So rather than going back again, you can just repeat how to open this.
Okay. Let me close the documents now. Just open one. And there I'm going with docs.google.com. You just directly type with this. If you have Gmail account, you can directly go to your docs by typing docs.google.com. I just have clicked this. And if I get inside, you will have, if you have previous presentations, you can open with that. I'm going with a blank presentation now. I'm just clicking on blank presentation. And here, I'm clicking on tools. Just click tools, where you will have voice typing. And if you want the shortcut of that, it is given like Control Shift S. I'm closing this and I'm pressing Control Shift S. It will bring you this icon on your left side. And it automatically goes with English US as default. So I'm just stopping this and just click on the small arrow key, which is here. And there you will find so many languages. You can ask whatever language you are going to type. You just select the language and start typing in that. It is as default English US. So if you want it in English, you can go with English India. So I click English India and just click on the mic icon again to make the system to type. It should come as red, like I'm clicking and I have started typing from here. Wherever you keep your cursor, it will start typing like this in that place. This is how, and you can also type in your regional language. And this is one beautiful input which I like in creating resources inside this Google Docs, which is interesting thing. And thank you for this. Let me close up to this, I guess. And let me stop. And I want to answer for the questions. Shall I, Niti ma'am, if you are asking?
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much, Dilip ji. A big Nandri. Thank you. Dhanyavad. And also I thank nearly 132 participants are watching you live and listening to your presentation. And thanks for introducing all the five different tools for language learning. And not only English, it also linked it to other languages. And yes, also how the four language skills, listening, speaking, reading and writing. So these can be linked together and holistic language development among children is students is possible. Now yes, we have some hands already raised and some people they have been asking some questions and giving you compliments. And thanking you for nice presentation. I request my colleague Dr. Nidhi to first consume the chart related questions so that we can take forward. And we have only one hand raised so far by Mr. Mr. or Miss Asu. So, and Anjali Munga. So two participants, they have raised their hand for the question. But I request Dr. Nidhi to first go to the people, those who have been writing on the chat.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. So there are a few questions. I'm clubbing few of them, two, three of them together because they are related. Okay. One is, can games be downloaded? Can be all, they are just online and how to download. You just showed it once. If you can again show them,
okay.
Download the games, that is games2learnenglish.com.
One second, I can do it.
Two, three questions together you can say so that we can sequence those. Yeah.
So two questions have been clubbed in this.
Okay.
Two, three questions have been clubbed in this.
Okay.
I'll share my screen and again I'll show.
Yes, sir.
I'll go back to this website. games2learnenglish.com is the page. Generally, it opens with the first one, games. Go to your games2learnenglish.com. By default, it will show you in this games side. Here, you will not find any download icon on the top menu. Just come down entirely. All these are online playing games. If you want to download it to your computer, you should come down and here you have download icon, like download link is here. Just click on this download and it will take you to this page where you can just click any of the game which you wish, or if you wish to download all, also possible. So if you click on this link below and it will This is for interactive whiteboard especially. It will give you all games which are for interactive whiteboard. The previous one is for normal computers. Just click on this and it will come here as downloaded as a RAR file. You just unzip it, just click and play. You are not going to set up anything. You're not going to install this into your Windows. It is click and play, that's all. And you are going to unzip this from the zip folder and click on the icon and you can play this. And there is one more secret behind this gaming is, I have also tried with incorporating tools of R, it will show you some vocabulary, and inside that vocabulary folder, if you insert your own vocabulary, which are from your book, it also takes that and gives that as a gamified one. And that is one amazing thing about this. I have done that also when we were trying to incorporate gamification as a project. And let me stop screen sharing here. I think I have...
Another question is that, what is the basic principle of language learning and how does it cater the basics of language learning?
Okay.
Actually, if I come here, this is a very theoretical question.
Yes, sir.
I request all of you, because all of us, we know there are basic four skills
yes,
that have to be developed. So these are few tools using which we can improve that. So how effectively you are going to use that is a $1 million question. And how to use these apps for our purposes, that is also required. And these basic questions you can Google and get also. And the PPT which Dilip sir is using and his video will be available on ciit.nic.in, CIIT website. You have to go to event and then webinar. So on webinar page, all the PPT and videos also, these videos are being recorded. So you'll be getting it. So please don't ask the basic language skills, that is everybody knowing, every teacher knowing. But how to develop that with a specific tool is a $1 million question. We need to learn more and more tools how to develop that, rather than going to the theory back. So rather linking that how multiple tools can do that. Dilip ji.
Thank you so much for the answer, sir. I wanted to add with this basic four skills are mandatory. Most of the times we fail to integrate all the four. One easy answer which I could say for developing the language is provide the exposure to the children and create an English atmosphere in your classroom. That will increase the English fluency amongst your children, is with my experience, 20 years of experience with teaching to children. That's the one we are trying to give and provide to our children. Exposure to the language is my answer. Thank you.
So the next question is that, can these tools be worked on mobile phones?
Yeah, I have shown some of those which are compatible to mobile also, which is for Android, iOS. Both it works with Apple as well as. And mobiles, almost I have shown web tools which are accessible as a website in any platform. It could be a tab or a mobile or anything. We haven't seen any software, shown any software. OneNote is also compatible with your mobile. There is an app which is available in Play Store. You can download it free of cost. But the learning tools are not available for mobile phones. It should be used in your computer, and you can connect that with your whiteboard and show it to your children is only possible way for that.
So the next question is, can we share these quizzes on Diksha or any other platform, and how to do it?
You can create this and you can share it as a link to email or anything. But as far as Diksha is concerned, there is a separate creation platform which is inbuilt with Diksha, and we used to create quizzes inside Diksha platform only, and their external sources like this are not advisable, because Diksha has a secured platform of quiz creation. If possible, I can handle one class on Diksha quiz creation. Entirely, it is different. There are, again, we have made a e-glossary, which is like a mini language library, which is also possible to create within Diksha itself. There are add-ons, n number of add-ons, which are provided by Diksha. It is not, we can't integrate that with Diksha, but we can integrate that with any other. Like you can give the link with Blogger, or you can integrate this with Google Classroom, or you can share this link to email or WhatsApp. Anything is possible, but not with Diksha. It is not advisable to share.
Thank you. And then next question is that, is Quizlet an Android app, and how many number of questions, what is the limit for of number of questions that can be embedded in this Quizlet?
Okay. The number of questions for free users are minimum, and you can already, there are many Quizlet options which are available, which were created on certain topics, which you can make use of that. Available quizzes, but for free version, I'm not sure, it could be around 50 and below 50 only, not above than that.
Okay.
I haven't tried more than 30 with this.
Mm-hmm. One question is coming that, do you think Quizlet is better than Kaboom?
No, Kahoot.
It's written Kaboom. I think Kahoot? They have missed Kahoot. Yes, Kahoot.
It should be Kahoot, I guess. Mm-hmm. Kahoot is an interactive tool which gives you only playing, and for only testing purpose we can use this. But I think that Quizlet is for entire package of learning. It gives you, if you share this as a Google platform, one is for learning, one is for understanding, another one is for testing, and another one is for playing. It, where you are typing once and it is giving you 5 to 6 options automatically created. But Kahoot will give you only quizzes which are easy to play, and it is used for testing purpose.
Okay, so all those questions there, those who came, that came in between, are over. I think no more question is there from anybody else. If somebody wants to ask, then
to raise their hands, I was telling, and
they have lowered it down, so maybe their question has been answered.
Two, three of them, they had raised their hand. So Dr. Nidhi is right, maybe their questions must be directly or indirectly answered by you. So they have withdrawn their hand.
Sir, we have given training in NISA regarding a school-based assessment.
Who is speaking? Please introduce yourself.
I am Shekhar from Tamil Nadu, Samagra Shiksha.
Welcome, Dr. Shekhar.
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir. How are you, sir?
Fine, thank you,
Nandri. Yes, sir. Last year we given NISA training, particularly for that school-based assessment. We have to create a tool for school-based assessment. Because we are giving training for teachers, but it will not be reflected in the classroom. So we have to create ICT tools for school-based assessment. School-based assessment, teacher assessment.
Yeah, thank you very much, Dr. Shekhar. Actually, we have a team of ICT expert in Tamil Nadu already. So start from them, and maybe NCRT faculty, they can be pitched in to evaluate those, validate those. Then you can go ahead with using that. But school-based assessments are necessarily to be developed by individual teachers. Not it is a standardized test, so developed by some third party. So that is why school-based assessments necessarily to be developed by teachers, practicing teachers. So go ahead with doing that. You use the expertise of Dilipji and other national ICT awardee and your team of ICT experts you have identified in the state. So thank you very much. Can we go to the next person?
Sir, there is a question. It says any tool for speaking test, I mean testing the speaking, I mean the language too.
I had been searching, like there is no language lab free of cost, but we can use some of the tools, like even the voice typing from Google can be used as a testing tool, because if you articulate it rightly only, it will type for you correct. So that we can convert that as a speaking testing tool. And there is no separate tool for testing the speaking. I can understand the question, like if you are conducting an oral test, the system test and give you marks? I'm not sure. I may not be aware of that. I have searched for that, but I didn't get an appropriate tool for that. But if anyone gets it, kindly share with everyone. And we had also searched for language lab, kind of any software free of cost, but it is not also available up to now.
All the questions are over now. So I think the time is also, we are getting, 4:30. Sir, can
okay.
bear a second.
Thank you very much, Dilip ji, for your lucid presentation and covering 5 important tools. I hope the participants, they enjoyed and they might have taken some cue. And I repeat for all of you that all these presentations which is made by the resource persons, including today's Dilip ji's presentation, it will be available on CIET website, ciet.nic.in. You can, after visiting our website, go to events. And in events, you find webinar. So all webinar topics also you can see there. You can register yourself also on any day for the webinar. And also you can see the PPTs and the videos which are recorded through these presentations, everything there. And once again, I request that you can register well in advance, since we are declaring the topics well in advance, so that 500 number we can have together. We can include 500 participants in this group. So, and also if you know an interesting tool which you can share with your friends and friends from other states and English language teachers from other states, or any other subject teaching, any web tool or any web application, so we will be happy to host you and take you to the grassroots level to every teacher. I thank first of all to Dilip ji.
Thank you so much, sir.
A big Nandri for accepting our invitation. And also I thank my colleague Dr. Nidhi for anchoring. And also I thank Devasis for taking providing technical support for this team. And I thank one and all of all the teachers, teacher educators, my NCERT colleagues for joining this important webinar. So we'll keep on interacting with you. So every day 3:30 to 4:30 without missing. So please join us every day and enrich each other's knowledge and also help in capacity building of our teachers and co-teacher colleagues in different parts of the country. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thank you so much for giving me this wonderful opportunity, sir. I thank Behera sir for giving me this wonderful opportunity. And again, I wholeheartedly thank all the participants who had given me a cooperation, the good cooperation for delivering these things. And Nidhi ma'am, thank you so much for coordinating. I thank Angel ma'am also and all the NCERT faculties who are along with sir for supporting.
Dr. Angel always works from background, from curtain, behind the curtain. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
There for all preparations. So thank you once again. Thanks to all of you.